ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ టు ఆల్. ఇన్ దిస్ క్లాస్ ఐ విల్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ రిలేటెడ్ టు వన్ ఆఫ్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ పీరియాడిక్ ప్రాపర్టీ. That is nothing but nature of oxides. Nature of oxides means what? When the given element interact with or combined with or react with the oxygen, resulting the formation of a compound known as oxide. And here the oxides may be acidic in nature or basic in nature or neutral, and that may be amphoteric. Okay, which elements are forming acidic oxides and which elements are forming basic oxides and which are forming amphoteric oxides and neutral oxides, and how does acidic nature of the oxides varies in a group, and how the acidic nature varies in a period? Not only acidic nature, that may be basic nature, whatever it may be, that we have to discuss. That is the one of the important fundamental property or fundamental periodic property which is useful to understand the behavior and nature of the element that are present in the periodic table. Right, in order to explain the nature of oxides, we should think about the tendency of the elements. Means what? Whether the atom of an element ready to lose electron or ready to gain electron, or some of the elements are either losing electrons or gaining electrons. And here this tendency of interaction of atom of an element with electron influences the nature of oxides. Influences the nature of oxides, that we have to discuss. And first one, tendency of losing electron. We have already familiar with the previous discussion that is related to electropositivity. What is electropositivity and what is metallic nature? Here the tendency of losing electron, is known as electropositivity. And here the electropositivity is the direct measure of metallic nature. So the elements which are having tendency of losing electron are electropositive. Here the electropositivity is the direct measure of metallic nature. Here the electropositivity is directly related to atomic radius. And inversely related to ionization potential. Electropositivity is nothing but metallic nature, direct measure. And here electropositivity depends upon atomic radius. This is the one of the factor that influences the metallic nature as well as electropositivity. Another periodic property that related with electropositivity is ionization potential. Okay. The elements which are having tendency of losing electron are metallic in nature, and they with high electropositivity, and they have large atomic radius and low IP values, and they used as good reducing agents. Good reducing agents means what? they readily or easily undergo oxidation. Easily undergo oxidation. Easily undergo oxidation, right? These are all interlinked. If you are properly following the explanation from the previous classes, you can easily understand all these concepts. These are all interlinked. These are all interlinked. Okay. Here, there is a statement. The oxides of metals are strongly basic in nature. Strongly basic in nature. The oxides of metals are strongly basic in nature or basic in nature. Okay. Here, what about the examples from first A group elements? Sodium oxide. From second A group elements, let us consider magnesium oxide. From third A group elements or any other metals, metal oxides, any metal oxides, that may be barium oxide, that may be strontium oxide, and that may be oxides of the zero group elements, whatever it may be, these are all examples to the basic oxides. How can you say these oxides are basic in nature? When sodium oxide added with water resulting the formation of sodium hydroxide. When water is added to the magnesium oxide resulting the formation of magnesium hydroxide. In the same way, calcium oxide with water that gives calcium hydroxide. And barium oxide with water that gives barium hydroxide. Barium hydroxide. These are all the metal oxides. These are all metal oxides. These are all strongly basic in nature. Strongly basic in nature. These are all the aqueous solutions of the respective oxides. Sodium oxide, magnesium oxide, calcium oxide and barium oxide. And here we can consider some of the oxides of D block elements also. They are also basic in nature. And same time, lanthanide oxides are also basic in nature. We can write this one also. Ln2O3 with water resulting the formation of lanthanide hydroxides. They are also basic in nature. Okay. But how do you identify the nature based on pH value? The pH of all these aqueous solutions greater than 7 means basic in nature. And concentration of H plus ions is less than that of concentration of OH minus ions. And concentration of H plus ions is less than that of 10 to the power of minus 7 mole per liter. And the aqueous solution turns red litmus to blue. These are all the important features of the aqueous solutions of the basic oxides which are given by metals. This is about the first statement given. Okay. But what about the second statement? Here we can give in a different way by comparing with this. Tendency of losing electrons is known as electropositivity. Quite opposite. Here, tendency of gaining electrons is known as electronegativity. Okay. Electronegativity is the direct measure of non-metallic nature. And electronegativity is inversely proportional to atomic radius and directly proportional to ionization potential. Directly proportional to ionization potential, inversely proportional to atomic radius, and here electronegativity is nothing but non-metallic character. Okay, when an atom gaining electrons, take for example, let us consider an atom A, this is a non-metal, it gains electron, then it forms anion. What is the oxidation state of A? Zero. What is the oxidation state of anion? Minus one. What happened to the oxidation state? Decreases. Means this is a reduction reaction. This is a reduction reaction. Means what? It oxidizes others. It oxidizes others. Here used as oxidizing agents. What is the characteristic property of oxidizing agent? That is readily undergo reduction. Undergo reduction. Undergo reduction. And here, from this we can make another statement. Here the oxides of non-metals, oxides of non-metals are electronegative elements are acidic in nature. Acidic in nature. Oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature. And here these oxides are used as oxidizing agents. They undergo reduction. They undergo reduction by gaining electrons. But here, used as reducing agents, they readily undergo oxidation. Means, suppose this is a metal atom, its oxidation state 0. It loses an electron resulting in the formation of cation. Loss of electron is known as oxidation. Gaining of electron is known as reduction. Here, when a substance or element used as reducing agent means, here it acts as reducing agent means, it undergo oxidation 0 to plus 1. Oxidation number increases. Therefore, this is oxidation. A reducing agent undergo oxidation. An oxidizing agent undergo reduction. Then only it acts as or used as oxidizing agent. That is the important point or twisting point of this one. Okay. Here, oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature. What are they? First one, carbon dioxide, 40th group element. Dinitrogen pentoxide, 50th group element. And next one, oxygen, nitrogen. And next one, sulfur trioxide. Phosphorus pentoxide, chlorine heptoxide. These are all examples to the non-metal oxide. These are all highly electronegative non-metals. Their oxides are acidic in nature. And here, how can you say and how can you prove? Here, when carbon dioxide added to the water resulting in the formation of carbonic acid. Carbonic acid. And when dinitrogen pentoxide added to the water to give nitric acid. When sulfur trioxide added to the water resulting in the formation of sulfuric acid. When phosphorus pentoxide added to the water, phosphoric acid, aqueous solution of phosphoric acid. When chlorine heptoxide added to the water resulting in the formation of perchloric acid. Perchloric acid, phosphoric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid, carbonic acid. These are all the aqueous solutions. They are nothing but the aqueous solutions of the oxides of non-metals. And same time, you have to go through other details. The pH of all these aqueous solutions is always less than that of 7. And concentration of H plus ions is greater than that of 10 power minus 7 mole per liter. and that is greater than that of concentration of OH minus ions. And same time, the aqueous solution turns blue litmus to red. This is about the concept that is related to the oxides of the metals and also non-metals. Here the metal oxides are basic in nature. Non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. This is about the nature of the aqueous solutions of metal oxides. This is about the nature of the aqueous solution of non-metal oxides. And the relative pH and concentration of ions in aqueous solution are like this. This is about the nature of oxides. Okay. Based on tendency of losing electron, we are giving this information. Based on tendency of gaining electron, we are giving this information. Okay. But some type of elements behaves differently and behaves peculiarly. How? They have tendency of either losing electron or gaining electron. Both tendencies are present in the same element. Such type of elements are known as metalloids. How can you define or how can you understand the word metalloid? The element which has a tendency of either losing electron or gaining electron are known as metalloids. Simply, the elements which are having both metallic and also non-metallic properties are also referred as metalloids. And here, this is about the metalloids. How can you define the word metalloid? The elements which are having the characteristics of both metals and non-metals, or the elements which are having the tendency of either losing electron or gaining electron, are referred as metalloids. What about the examples to the metalloids? Here, examples to the metalloids are gallium, germanium, indium, tin. Okay, indium, tin, these are all examples to the metalloids. And we can give some other examples also: arsenic, antimony, and zinc, aluminium. Aluminium actually metal based on SRP value, but its oxide is amphoteric in nature. Okay, and here these are all examples to the metalloids. Most of the metalloids are present in P block. And their oxides are amphoteric in nature. And here, what about the examples? Ga2O3 and GeO2, Im2, InO2, SnO2. Indium, gallium, greater than phosphorus, arsenic, antimony. Okay. In2O3, SnO2. Yeah, these are all the amphoteric oxides. Another example, As2O3. Next, Sb2O3. These are all the amphoteric oxides. And here, when these oxides are added to the water, resulting the formation of their aqueous solutions. Here, aqueous solutions of amphoteric oxides amphoteric oxides having pH nearly 7. H plus ion concentration is nearly same as that of OH minus ion concentration, nearly equal to 10 power minus 7 mole per liter. And this aqueous solution neutral with litmus paper. Neutral with litmus paper. And this is about the oxides of the metalloids here. Oxides of the metalloids are amphoteric in nature, and these are all examples. And the aqueous solution of the amphoteric oxide having the pH values like that and concentration of H plus ions and OH minus ions nearly equal to 10 power minus 7 mole per liter. And the aqueous solution is neutral with the litmus paper. And some other elements in the periodic table are also forming amphoteric oxides, even though they do not come under the class metalloids. Actually, they are metals, but their oxides are amphoteric in nature. What is the reason for that? There is a special property is responsible for that. That is nothing but diagonal relation. Okay, what about the example for that? Alumina, beryllium oxide, zinc oxide, lead monoxide, stannous oxide, stannic oxide, slightly, very slightly basic in nature, stannic oxide. These are all the amphoteric oxides. Actually, aluminum is a metal. Beryllium is weakly metallic in nature. Zinc is a metal. Lead is a metal. Okay, tin is the metalloid. Okay, and here, these are all the already given here. These are all amphoteric oxides. Their aqueous solutions are amphoteric in nature. Okay. How can you explain the amphoteric nature of all these oxides? Example. Let us consider aluminium oxide. Okay. Aluminium oxide react with hydrochloric acid. This is acid, resulting in the formation of aluminium chloride and forming water. In the first example, aluminium oxide reacts with hydrochloric acid, resulting in the formation of a salt, aluminium chloride. This is salt. Okay. In the second case, aluminium oxide added to sodium hydroxide, that is basic oxide already known to you, resulting in the formation of sodium meta-aluminate and forming water. 2Na, 2Al, and next one to 4. Okay. That is about the reactions. Here, alumina reacts with acid, resulting in the formation of salt. Alumina reacts with base, resulting in the formation of salt. Means what? In the first reaction, alumina acts as base. In the second reaction, alumina acts as acid. Means what? Oxide, which has both acidic and also basic characters. Oxide which has both acidic and also basic characters is known as amphoteric oxide. Why it reacts with acid, it behaves like a base. While it reacts with base, it behaves like an acid. Means, based on the nature of the other substance that react, it changes its nature. If it is ready to react with acidic oxide, then it behaves like a base. It is ready to react with a basic oxide, then it is ready to act as acid. means what? Based on the nature of the other substance that react, it changes its nature. Means what? It has both acidic character and also basic character. Such type of oxides are known as amphotericic oxides. This is the proof. And another example, beryllium oxide reacts with hydrochloric acid to give beryllium chloride and forming water. And same beryllium oxide when treated with sodium hydroxide to give sodium berylite, and forming water. Here this is salt and this is also salt. In the first case, beryllium oxide acts as base. Why? Here that react with acid. In the second case, beryllium oxide acts as acid. Why? It react with base. It has both acidic and also basic characters. As a result of that, here these are all represented as amphoteric oxides. This is about the concept that related to the nature of oxides. Next one. What about the periodicity? How does nature of oxides varies in a period? And how does it varies in a group? That is the periodicity. First one, group. In a group, as we move from top to bottom, with increase of atomic radius, electropositivity increases and electronegativity decreases. And here, whatever it may be the group, no problem. That is lithium oxide, sodium oxide, potassium oxide, rubidium oxide, and cesium oxide. From lithium to cesium, atomic radius increases, electropositivity increases, metallic nature increases. Therefore, from top to bottom, with increase of atomic radius, electropositivity increases, and next one, metallic nature increases. And here, what is the nature of the metal oxides? Basic. Therefore, basic nature of oxides increases. And what about the order of the basic nature of these oxides? This is the order of the basic nature of the oxide. Cesium oxide is the strongest base. So, the strongest known base is cesium hydroxide, aqueous solution of cesium oxide. And same time you can compare in the halogens also. As we move from top to bottom, atomic radius increases, therefore electronegativity decreases. With the decrease of electronegativity, acidic nature increases. Acidic nature increases means basic nature of oxides increases. That is about the periodicity of the nature of oxides in a group. From top to bottom, basic nature of the oxides increases. Means what? Acidic nature of the oxides decreases. Basic nature of oxides increases. What is the reason for that? These are the reasons for that, right? And here the next one, what about the variation of the nature of oxides in a period? In a period, from left to right, with the decrease of atomic radius, effective nuclear charge increases, ionization potential increases, electronegativity increases, and non-metallic nature increases. What is the nature of oxides of non-metals? Acidic nature. Then you can give the statement. In a period, as we move from left to right, the acidic nature of oxides increases, means basic nature of oxides decreases. Example, sodium oxide, magnesium oxide, aluminium oxide, phosphorus pentoxide, sulfur trioxide and chlorine heptoxide. And here, from left to right in the period, atomic radius decreases, effect on nuclear charge increases, electronegativity increases, non-metallic nature increases. Look at the correlation between the periodic properties. As the non-metallic nature increases or electronegativity increases, nature of oxides here, nature of oxides is acidic in nature, and acidic nature of oxides from left to right increases. Means what? Therefore, basic nature of oxides from left to right decreases. Okay, acidic nature increases, basic nature decreases. Sodium oxide, strong base. Magnesium oxide, base or basic in nature. Aluminum oxide, we have already familiar, amphoteric. Silicon dioxide, weakly acidic. Phosphorus pentoxide, weakly acidic. Sulfur trioxide, acidic. Perchloric acid, strongly acidic. And now we can make another important objective point of view. Strongest known acid is perchloric acid. Perchloric acid, HClO4, strongest known acid in the form of aqueous solution is perchloric acid. And strongest known base is cesium hydroxide, aqueous solution of cesium oxide. Here, from strong base, first element strong base, and oxide of the last element strongly acidic in nature. So, from left to right, the acidic nature of oxides from left to right increases, and basic nature of oxides decreases. This is about the periodicity of the nature of oxides. Periodicity of the nature of oxides in long form periodic table. And there is another convenience is also there. From this we can compare the non-metallic nature and metallic nature, and we can realize the relation between the non-metallic nature and electronegativity and metallic nature and electropositivity. And same time, all these non-metal oxides are used as oxidizing agents. But here, all these oxides are used as reducing agents. Here, the reducing nature directly proportional to basic nature. So, among all these oxides, which one of the following is the strongest reducing agent? Here, cesium oxide. Strongest reducing agent is cesium oxide. Cesium oxide. And in the same way, here these non-metal oxides are used as oxidizing agents. With increase of non-metallic character, with increase of electronegativity of the element, here the acidic nature of oxides increases. Means what? Here oxidizing nature increases from left to right. Therefore, oxidizing tendency also increases from left to right.
from left to right.
And here, strongest known oxidizing agent. Strongest known oxidizing agent is perchloric acid. This is the aqueous solution of this one. When it is added to the water to give perchloric acid, this is the strongest known oxidizing agent. And here this is the strongest known reducing agent. So, from the nature of oxides, we can cover all these topics. We can understand the relation between the periodic properties of the elements. And we can evaluate the nature of the element. Here, reducing nature directly proportional to basic nature of oxides, and oxidizing nature directly proportional to acidic nature of the oxides. Here, oxidizing nature directly proportional to acidic nature of oxides. Acidic nature of oxides. This is about the concept related to the nature of oxides. And next one. Next one. Diagonal relation. Here the next one. Diagonal relation. What is the diagonal relation? In long form periodic table, particularly in representative elements, that too from first year to fourth year group elements. Got my point? In long form periodic table, in representative elements, from first to fourth year group elements, the first element of each group of second period element chemically similar with the second element of next group of third period. That phenomenon is known as diagonal relation. That phenomenon is known as diagonal relation. If you are understanding the definition properly, then you have no need to feel hurry. What is the definition? In long form periodic table, in representative element, from first to fourth year group elements, the first element of each group of the second period resembled with the second element of the next group of the third period in the properties. That phenomenon is known as diagonal relation. I will give the example, then you can easily understand the concept. Here, this is second period and this is third period. Second period and third period. From first year to fourth year group elements. What are the second period elements? Lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon. Third period elements, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silica. In long form periodic table, in representative elements, from first year to fourth year groups, the first element of each group of second period resembled with the second element of next group of third period in the properties. That phenomenon is known as diagonal relation. Here, this is about the diagonal relation. Lithium diagonally related with magnesium. Beryllium diagonally related with aluminium. Boron diagonally related with silicon. Okay. And what about the important points that are related to diagonal relation? Here, among all these groups of second and third period elements,
carbon and sodium do not exhibit diagonal relation.
Carbon and sodium do not exhibit diagonal relation. Lithium diagonally related with magnesium. Beryllium diagonally related with aluminium. Boron diagonally related with silicon. But the element that are not exhibit diagonal relation are sodium and carbon.
And diagonal relation disappears beyond fourth year group. Diagonal relation disappears beyond fourth A group. After fourth A group, there is no diagonal relation. And here the reason for the diagonal relation are, first one, similar atomic radii and also ionic radii.
That means lithium and magnesium ions, example,
Li plus ion is similar or closer ionic radii as Mg2 plus. And second one, similar electronegativity values.
Similar electronegativity values.
Example same. We can take either beryllium and aluminium also. Beryllium electronegativity 1.5. Aluminium electronegativity is also 1.6, nearly same. And third one, similar polarizing power. Similar polarizing power, eta.
And what about the polarizing power?
Polarizing power is equal to charge by radius square.
The ratio between the charge of the cation and its radius is nothing but polarizing power.
It is applicable for only cations. It is applicable for only cations.
And these are the reasons for the diagonal relation. What are the reasons? Similar atomic and ionic radii, similar electronegativity values, and similar polarizing powers.
Similar polarizing power.
Okay. What are the consequences of the diagonal relation?
The only one consequence, that is similarity in the properties, already given in the definition.
Similarity in the property. How can you explain?
Example 1. Among first year group elements, only lithium, when heated in atmospheric air, resulting the formation of lithium nitride. And among second A group elements, magnesium react with nitrogen. Magnesium react with nitrogen, resulting the formation of Mg3N2, magnesium nitride.
Here, lithium and magnesium, when the two elements are burned in presence of atmospheric air, they combine with both oxygen and also nitrogen. Okay, go for that also. When lithium heating with air or oxygen presence of atmospheric air, resulting the formation of lithium oxide, and magnesium forming magnesium oxide. Here both are weakly basic in nature. Both are weakly basic in nature. Why? They are less metallic in nature. And in the same way, they combine with nitrogen and resulting the formation of their respective nitrides. When these nitrides subjected to the hydrolysis, resulting the formation of their respective hydroxide and liberating ammonia gas, 2NH3, 3 into 2, 6, 3. And next one, Li3N plus water, resulting the formation of Li2O, 3Li2O plus NH3.
plus NH3 means 2NH3, ammonia gas is liberated. This is due to diagonal relation. Second example, beryllium diagonally related with aluminium. Here both beryllium oxide and aluminium oxides are amphoteric in nature. Means here both these oxides react with both acids and also bases, and resulting the formation of salts. And when beryllium carbide, when beryllium carbide subjected to hydrolysis to give beryllium oxide and liberating methane gas. And in the same way, when aluminium carbide subjected to the hydrolysis, resulting the formation of aluminium hydroxide and liberating methane gas. Liberating methane gas. Liberating methane gas. This is about the similarity in the properties due to diagonal relation. Example 1 and example 2. Example 2. This is about the diagonal relation. And here, before closing this topic, you should realize what is the meaning of polarizing power. Here, polarizing power is concerned with cations. And this is nothing but the tendency of a cation to attract the electron cloud of the anion towards itself. Means what? Take for example, let us consider a cation. When this cation comes closer with the anion, suppose this is anion. When both cation and anion come closer with each other, here this cation attracting or pulling the electron cloud towards itself. As a result of that, this electron cloud undergo contraction and diffuse towards cation. This phenomenon is known as polarizing power. Here polarizing power is inversely related to the size. Means what? In case of cation, with increase of the charge, the size gradually decreases. As charge increases, size decreases. Take for example, let us consider three cations, Na plus, Mg2 plus, Al3 plus. And here, this is the order of decreasing of the size. Why? Here, the charge of the cation increases, means size decreases. With the decrease of the size, polarizing power increases. Here, these are all interlinked. And here, the polarizing power is inversely related to the radius of the cation, size of cation. Here, size of cation is inversely related to polarizing power. Greater the charge, smaller the size. Smaller the size, greater is the polarizing power. Means, with increase of the charge of the cation, the size gradually decreases and polarizing power increases. This is about the polarizing power. Polarizing power. It played an important role during the formation of covalent bonds. Here polarizing power decides the type of the bond formed between the two atoms. So due to similar polarizing power, similar electronegativity, similar atomic and ionic radii, here the elements exhibit similarities in the properties that are related to second and third periods, and that phenomena is referred as diagonal relation. This is about the details that are related to periodic table. In the next class, we have to discuss about the doubts that arise to the students, and some other small concepts are there. We can discuss in the next class.